city of Rome, where a family named Claudius. They were rich and noble, but their greatest asset was their daughter, Agnes. Agnes, as her name means, was calm and gentle as a lamb. She was kind-hearted and as beautiful as a bride. Then one day, a boy named Procopio, who was the son of the prefect of Rome, approached her. "Stop, Agnes. I want to talk to you. Agnes, you are beautiful and kind-hearted. I wish to marry you someday. I am already engaged and I belong only to him who has angels for servants and owns heaven. He will be my spouse. He alone." Procopio went away, sad and broken. He did not understand what Agnes meant. His father said the same. "What happened to you, son? Why are you so sad? The woman I love has rejected me." Then one day, a servant of Procopio's father told the prefect the reason for Agnes rejecting Procopio.
"Your Majesty, I know why Agnes refused your son. She must be a Christian. There are many young women who refuse to marry because they love someone named Jesus Christ."
The prefect was shocked and furious. He was a pagan worshiper himself and hated Christianity, so he decided to threaten Agnes and his family. He called them to the court to make her marry Procopio, his son. Meanwhile, at Agnes's house, her mother was frightened.
"Under his majesty, King Alexander will right hand over the Roman Empire, doubtless over the empires of Rome. His Highness, the prefect of Rome, Sempronius, has ordered Claudius Agnes to surrender before him and marry Procopio, the son of prefect Sempronius."
"Mother, have courage. Do not cry for me. Jesus will protect me. I will not give up my faith."
Agnes was brought to the king as ordered by the prefect.
"Do you know why I'm here?"
"Yes, because I'm a Christian."
"Foolish girl, what day? Because of you, my son is suffering. Are they ready to marry him? Or I shall kill you."
"I'm the spouse of Jesus. This spouse alone. I fear nothing. I can suffer for Jesus' sake. There is an angel guarding me and he will not let Christ's child suffer harm."
"You are too bold. You have rejected my son. You will face the consequences for this."
Agnes was dragged to the main streets. She was tortured, beaten and beaten. She was asked to worship pagan gods. But instead, she made the sign of the cross. Agnes did all things for Jesus' sake. She gave her hand and sang praises to God.
"Oh, to Jesus, I surrender. Oh, to him I I will never love and trust in his
girls.